الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى علي وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد حبت في الله, one of the reasons that we have love for the ulama sunnah and the salaf salih رضوان الله عليهم, those who preserve the religion of Islam, is for that very fact that they help to preserve the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam. And their preservation of the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam, it comes through ilm, it comes through knowledge. There's no shortcuts when it comes to the various issues and masail and things that we face, and we want to understand the religion. We can only understand the religion not through just sitting in a closet with the lights out, or just making dhikr with no input from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, meaning reading the Kitab Allah, wala sunnah Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but it is through ilm, it is through an active pursuit of ilm, and through the guidance, first and foremost, of Allah tabaraka ta'ala, thumma, then His creation, which is Ahlul Ilm, because they are the warath al-anbiya, they are the inheritors of the prophets, and they didn't inherit wealth. They inherited knowledge and hikmah on how to practice the book and the sunnah of the messengers, alayhim afdal salatu wassalam. And we often mention about who the saved sect is. You know, what are the characteristics? Because there is a saved sect, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith of Iftiraq. Nabiyyina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Iftarakat al-Yahud ala 71 firqa, wa iftarakat al-Nasara ala 72 firqa. وَسَتَفْتَارِكُ هَذِهِ أُمَّةِ عَلَى ثَلَاثَ وَسَبْعِينَ فِرْقَ كُلَّهَا فِي النَّارِ إِلَّا وَاحِدَ كُلْنَا مَنْ هِيَ يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ قَالَ مَنْ كَانَ عَلَى مِثْلِي وَمَا كَانَ عَلَيْهِ وَأَصْحَابِي الْيَوْمِ. The Prophet ﷺ mentioned that the Jews would break into 71 sects, the Christians into 72 sects. His nation, meaning the nation of Muslims, those who are supposed to follow the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, would break into 73 sects, all of them in the fire except one. And they said, those Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een, they said, who are they, Ya Rasulullah? You know, who are these ones who are going to be saved from the fire? And that's why they're referred to as the saved sect. They are saved from what? They're saved from the fire. Because that's what it's all about. It's all about ibadah. It's all about coming closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, doing what Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala wants from us, and avoiding His prohibitions. And so they said, who are they, Ya Rasulullah? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, those who are upon what I'm upon and my companions are upon, al-yawm. And so that shows us that in general, that gives us the general qa'ida, the general rule, the general asl, the general usul, the general foundation of what, how we want to practice and understand our religion, that it's based upon the book and the sunnah, and how the and the sunnah of the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een, meaning those things they were united upon. And one of the things that they were united upon was their creed, their ittiqad. Shaykh al-Islam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentions a big fa'idah about the importance of the people of knowledge. And an aspect of the people of knowledge, or a characteristic of the people of knowledge, he said, وَإِذَا كَانَتْ سَعَادَةَ الْأَوَّلِينَ وَالْآخِرِينَ هِيَ بِإِتِّبَاعِ الْمُرْسَلِينَ فَمِنْ مَعْلُومٍ أَنَّ أَحَقَّ النَّاسِ بِذَلِكَ أَعْلَمُهُمْ بِآثَارِ الْمُرْسَلِينَ وَأَتْبَعَهُمْ لِذَلِكَ فَعَالِمُونَ بِأَقْوَالِهِمْ وَأَفْعَالِهِمْ وَمُتَّبِعُونَ لَهَا هُمْ أَهْلَ السَّعَادَةِ فِي كُلِّ زَمَانٍ ومكان وهم طائفة الناجي ناجية من أهل كل ملة وهم أهل السنة والحديث من هذه أمة. So he mentioned, he said, if happiness, the happiness of those people who preceded us, meaning those other nations, those earlier nations, and the nations of in Islam, meaning the nations after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as with those who came before the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, those nations that followed their anbiya, that followed their prophets, alayhim afdal salatu wasalam. He said, if their happiness from the earlier generations, if you will, and the later ones came from following the messengers, then it is well known that the most people befitting, or the most people who fall under this characteristic, is the people who have the most knowledge of the narrations or sunnah of the mursaleen, of the, you know, the messengers. And those who are most adherent in following them. Again, so what is that? That's ilm wa amal. That's knowledge and practice. So it isn't just that they have knowledge, that they memorize, they know what the Anbiya said, or they know what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, meaning they know the sunnah, they memorize something from the sunnah, this and that and the other, without practice. La. He said, the most knowledge of their narrations and the most adherent to them. And then he said, therefore, those people who are the most knowledgeable about their statements and their actions, and the most adherent to following them, they are the people of happiness during all times and in every place. And they are the successful sect, the successful sect or group from every faith, every religion, meaning those people who followed their Anbiya, who followed in the time of Jesus alayhi salatu wasalam, or Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, or all the various Anbiya, that the followers of those prophets alayhim afdhal salatu wasalam, their followers that adhered to them and had that knowledge, because they required knowledge in order to adhere to the sunnah, then they were they're the successful ones. He said, "Wuhum ahla sunnah." So talking about in our ummah, "Wuhum ahla sunnah." They are the people of the sunnah. Wal hadith, and hadith from this ummah. So that's a great faida from Dura Saniya. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, to bless us to be from Ahla Hadith, to be of those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with, who adhere to the book and the sunnah. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.